I was recently given a puzzle about a spider and a fly, and I wasn't really happy with the answer that I gave. So after that, I kept thinking about it, and I researched it, and now I think I have a solution to it. So here's the problem. We have a room. Cuboid. This corner here, there's a spider. And in this corner up here, there is a fly. The question and the problem is, what is the shortest route for the spider to get to the fly? Because they're friends. So, if it was the fly getting to the spider, that would be quite easy, because it would just fly in a straight line. But the spider has to move across the walls. So that's harder. It's got to move. It can't go through the air. So that was the puzzle. Now let's look at an interesting solution. If there was a straight line available for the spider to take, then the solution would be clear, because a straight line is always the shortest path. But we don't have a straight line for the spider to take. Or do we? With a little bit of magic, we can make a straight line. So here is my room, and here is my magic. Not many people can do that. I made the walls fall flat. But why does that help? I'll show you why if you follow me to my desk now. So, this is my table. And this is the flattened room. Now, let the sides of the room be A from here to here, B, and C as its original height. Now, the spider is at the moment here, in this corner. The fly, however, is here. So when we flatten the room, it's here and here. So in 3D we have the flies here, but in 2D we have two flies. So let's make the dot in 3D. There. So we have a red spot in both places. Let's just make it more clear. So the spider is here and the bee is here. So the spider can take two routes at the moment if we use a straight line. One is this route, and the other is this route. Now, it's easy to find the lengths of these two paths if you know Pythagoras, especially if he's your next door neighbour, because we can use his theorem to calculate them. In this right angle triangle, this is the hypotenuse and these are the legs. So this hypotenuse or path is equal to a plus c squared plus b squared and the square root out of all that. So this is the square root of a plus c squared plus b squared Now the other path is the hypotenuse of this right angle triangle. So the length of that is the square root of b plus c squared plus a squared. So the square root of b plus c squared plus a squared. But there's a third path that we can find if we open the room up in a slightly different way. This is the room. This here is the spider. And up here we have the fly. So here. I have already drawn this, so. And for the spider, it doesn't matter how you open the room because it still has to keep to the walls. So we can open it up like this. And the spider has to come from here to here or to here, which is the same length. And this, the length of this, we can use the Pythagorean theorem again, because the hypotenuse of this right angle triangle, the length of it is the square root of a plus b squared plus c squared. So let's come back to our drawing. This was a, this was b, and this was side C. The lengths of our three different paths were the square root of A plus B squared plus C squared, the square root of A plus C squared plus B squared, and the square root of b plus c squared plus a squared. Now, let's put these into a set. And throw the set into a minimum function. Now, let's see what the paths actually look like on the drawing. So one of the paths, the spider goes along the left wall and then along the back wall to the corner. That is path number one. Path number two, the spider crawls along the front wall, the closest one to us, and then along the ceiling. That's number two. And number three, the spider crawls along the floor, and then along the back wall. That's number three. So which one of these paths is actually the shortest, so which one the spider takes, is dependent on the size of the room itself, or basically the lengths of A, B and C. So that concludes our magical solution. And I hope to see you at school. Bye.